Hello everybody and welcome back to my Monster Hunter World Hunting Horn run, and today, if I'm right about things, I know I've been wrong before. I believe today's the time we get to go down to the Rottenville and face Odogaron. Alright, so we've talked to the Fur Fleet Master and now we get to explore the Rottenville more. Sorry, gotta clear my throat a bit. Yes, I open a window to try and get some air in here too. Well, some cool air. Hopefully things go better this episode than last episode with Legiana. Oh boy. That's part of the charm of doing a run with a weapon you're not very familiar with or hardly ever use. You're learning on the fly. Sure, there's a training area where I can actually learn how to attack, but applying it to the actual monsters is another thing. After all, the training area is full of stationary targets that don't fight back. Well, we made it. New assignment available. Into the bowels of the Vale.
I have a feeling I know what the Rotten Vale is. Slow and careful.
Yeah, even the handler's got to cover up. Alright, looks like we're on a timer, so... yeah, let's get to looking. And speaking of which... ooh. There's a Zoramadris track, so...
Nothing can stop us.
Where could it... yeah, I'll grab that Wiggly Lichy. Yeah, I probably should have ate beforehand, but...
wait, I'm going to...
oh, a handler's going to join us! Yay!
Dinner.
And since we got our first clue... well, yeah. Wow. I've never seen this before. Well, in my other playthrough I have, but for the purpose of this character... ooh, got some Dragonite ore here too. Wait, more tracks. There's more stuff here. Mind. Please don't mind.
The traces, but...
whoa, that's a big one. Truly is. You got like how with the girl's armor, my character almost looks like either a witch doctor or a crow. My character kind of looks like a crow cowboy.
But what happened to Zoramadris? There's no place else for it to go.
Or Marty Skrull? I hope I pronounced his name right.
I think we should split up and go.
Oh, there's El Doggo! Odogaron. Big, meaty dog. He's got claws on claws. Oh.
What are you doing? Go!
Thanks for helping. You're hitting that thing with gas? Come on.
Don't stop. Keep going.
Okay, that's interesting news. Yeah. Look. She's doing this so you can get to
no,
see.
She can't hold that thing off. We've got to help her.
Oh, don't worry. I'll take care of it. Yep, now we have a doggo. We have to take down the doggy. Alright, based on this. Might be best. Same, go this way. Grab this honey. Alright, got one of my next potions back. And time to get my regular potion back, too. Whoa! Doggy, don't mess around. I gotta be careful here. And I kinda made a mistake before coming here. I forgot to get some Astera jerky. Yeah, it's important. It would be important to get the Astera jerky because of what Ogron can cause. Yep, bleeding. So it's telling me to crouch to heal it, so I'll do that for now. Because if I bleed again, I'm gonna show the other way. We can rid ourselves of bleeding. Or other ways. Up so that I'm not taking as much damage. I think the only other one I could make use of is taking the use reduced. I gotta find my opportunity, like right here. If I can extend it. I wasn't in a good spot there. Alright, Eldoggo's running away. And kind of think of it, I think I should too. I should buff myself up a bit. Don't worry, at least it's a 50-minute quest, so I can take advantage. I got small. So, I'm not getting any fresh ingredients, so yeah, let's do this one. Get a little defensive boost. I'm kind of rearranging myself. Well, physically rearranging how I sit. Another bitter bug. Yeah, that egg. All right. And that meal is helping me out in a way. I managed to get Eldoggo in the body shot. Oh no. Well, since I'm bleeding again, I might as well show. No, Eldoggo. Mulberry's not working. It was a stair jerky. Alright, I need this cleanser booster now. And I also need this mega potion. Because I took too much damage that I need it. I thought no berries would work, but it's just a stare of jerky. And I'm going. Oh, I have one set up. Ooh! yeah. That's what making it so hard to deal. This doggy is so hard to deal with just a, with such a heavy weapon type. I got knocked down. Yeah, now if I can break it. Well, I can break its face. It's well, its face, its claws. Tail's cuttable, but I can't cut it with a hunting horn. Going. Grab me a mic scene. And we got a doggy to deal with. And I'll grab this honey. It'll rebuff my mega potions a bit. And oh look, we're in an area where this gas would normally affect me. But because of that waste, it doesn't affect me at all. Yeah, the Gyarados waste in low rank. Alright, now I can boost. Just about everything that matters. Alright, got. I don't know if that was me or the Gyarados. But I want to say it's the Gyarados. Actually, kind of think of it, I don't really mean. Alright. I think I got at least one of the forms going. And another knockdown and a paralysis. So I gotta thank those Gyarados for helping me out. Oh boy. I wanna thank the cat for that. No, you're not going to burn me up today. Well, you're not going to get your bites in this time. Oh, I did not evade that well. Alright, got paralysis in. Well, another one. Gyarados are really showing how effective paralysis can be on a Dogoron. Because I'm sure not. Alright, at least I unequipped the. Well, I sheathed my horn. So now I'm at it. Might as well use my last first aid med. Alright, that at least gives me a rebuff. Oh boy. I think I'm gonna have to keep this mega potion in my mouth now. Although how I can drink a mega potion through a nest is beyond my understanding. And Doggy runs away. Is that? No, it's not. I was hoping to find that one drop, but I think I screwed up my shot at it. And actually, before I move on, I better sharpen. Oh, and Great Gyarados is here too. Hey, you gotta try it, revenge. Alright, get a defense boost. I don't know how much of that damage is actually on the Great Gyarados itself. I think I went for offense a bit too much there. But Great Gyarados material is going to help. Oh. Oh no. I managed to break its tail, but that's about all I can do with the tail. And Doggy's really mad now. And really tired. So tired and angry that I couldn't even get defense buff in. But you know what? I at least got something going. Alright, got a trip. Feels like sometimes I can get something going and other times. Alright. Doggy's running away. Time for the piercing pod. And I'll grab these herbs. Actually, I can't go up that way at all. Wait a minute. Where'd Doggy go? Oh, Doggy retreat. So I'll do my fast travel. And had I made some tranks earlier, I would have captured it, but I didn't, so I'm screwed in that sense. But at least I know where Doggy went. Herbs too. Alright, well, time to play a song to wake you up. course, I did not take full advantage of the situation. Yeah, and doggy can jump from the walls. Very agile dog. Yeah, he's been a bad boy. Get that one out of the way too. Oh no. Oh no, I need my cleanser. No wait, my cleanser booster. Alright, now I need this. So I can heal up proper. This is a nice thing. The longer you go before your encore, the more buffs you can add. So I got ice resist boost, which I probably could have used against Legiana. But so far, I'm doing alright with O-Dog. Booster's done. I think I managed to hit Eldalgo. Oh, it's gonna run away. Well, I'm gonna gather these bones then. Since you want nothing to do with me. Or you were in an arena where you had some great advantages. Wanted to look at the distance, but I interrupted it's you time. So hopefully it doesn't become chew time. C-H-E-W. Alright. Doggy drops an item. Oh, and luckily it landed right in. Oh. It jumped out of the way, that Paratoad. It would have been nice to get that para. But. But it's still in an arena where it has an advantage. Alright, now we got Eldalgo. Well, let's see, there's our doggy. Let's carve. Ooh, got a fang. Another fang. And a sinew. Hmm, that's good. Yeah, now let's check some of these hidden areas if we can. Alright, that's nothing. Ooh, there's something over there. Mite seeds! And lots of them. Slash berries, which I can't use. That slicing ammo is gonna go. Well, it has to go. Well, it took a while, but finally he took down Odogaron. Get some help from some Gyarados and Great Gyarados.
Where is she? I thought she'd be with you.
Well, as soon as I got to fight El Doggo, she was gone. No. Oh, there she is.
You're not.
She knew you'd look.
You're not hurt.
Yeah.
Thank you. I was planning to hide until it moved on, but, well, save me the trouble. Now, that's enough.
I guess, yeah, she didn't want to do it with El Doggo, but knew she had to just protect the handler.
Now tell me everything. What did you feel out there?
A sense of danger.
I think the Vale is where the monsters come to die.
It's
graveyard. Their graveyard, and this whole land is a vast ecosystem revolving.
Well, there is supposed to be a Dalamador skull around here.
Here. Come on.
And it seems not everything comes to die. Some monsters make this their ecosystem to live.
You're right. The Vale is where monsters come to rest.
Oh.
They sense the end and make their way here.
Oh, so the ones that make it long enough
become nutrients that
come here
the
to
coral highlands.
And when they pass and on, their bodies decompose and become the coral highlands.
Which after a cycle returns to the Vale to die again.
Oh, the circle of life.
It's an ecological marvel.
If I were any good at editing, I'd make a tiny Odogaron. Being held by Musaki.
Have you really considered the important question?
What's that?
Who's at the heart of it? What monster could serve as the nutrients for a system this large?
You don't.
What's the mystery behind the Elder Crossing? You know the answer.
Zora Mangaris?
They die here.
Bingo! An Elder's death is the catalyst. Oh. The Vale is Zora Mangaris' resting place.
So basically, when Zora Mangaris died, well, a Zora Mangaris died, it became the Coral Highlands. In the Rhyme.
Or at least it should be. The clues are all here. But Zora is nowhere to be found.
It was drawing in energy, storing it as it moved on.
Was
it trying to deliver it somewhere?
I don't know.
This one.
But I know who might. The first Wyverians have lived here much longer than us. Seek them out. Look, it's raining light.
Huh. Weird. So life are these leaves. Alright, I'm probably not the best at to explain any of this.
If only I could live another 300 years.
Oh.
Maybe that would be just long enough to see the end of this changing of the guard.
So.
Friends, you go finish this. I want to stay here a while longer.
So.
See what death has to give and life has to bring.
So, she wants us to finish the job she started. If you learn more about this circle of life. Alright, let's get our stuff. So it feels like what she's saying is obviously the Rotten Vale and the Coral Highlands are connected. Monsters come to die at the Rotten Vale and their nutrients form the coral, well, feed the Coral Highlands. So it's like when they decompose, their body becomes nutrients in which the Coral Highlands sustains itself. As I said, Azor Madras had died there in the past, but this one didn't. It moved on. So the nutrients it carries is going somewhere else. But where would it be going? I guess that's our job to find out. That makes you think of Hodogoron, Radaban, and Great Gyros. They're part of that ecosystem, not...
Good to see you.
They didn't come there to die. They're part of the ecosystem there. Well, we got... Alright, so... Zoramedris didn't go there to die. We need... We're still... at no clue why.
You can do this!
So...
The first Wyverians might be able to tell us where Zoramagdoros is.
I guess next is the first Wyverian. And they want us to go to Ancient Forest before anything else. Well, to find some clues. So let's talk to our team... to the team leader. What is it they came out with? Ooh, a vitality mantle. That's actually good in that it allows you to take some damage while you're wearing it. And my list means I need to visit the canteen again. The Tatar Meowskiller Chef. Hey. Well, yeah. The meat of the matter, say. Alright, so we've got another delivery quest, so maybe I'll make that an entire video. As I might. We got armory. We need something from us, too. That's going alright. Oh, you got new stuff available. Alright, let's see what you got. Alright, you got new alloy armor. So, yeah. What about weapons? Yeah, same as always. But, let's see what we can make at the smithy. Can we make anything new? No. Alright, what about upgrades? Radaban tree. Alright, looks like Eldalgo does not give us a horn. Someone check armor. We got two different kinds of armor. We got Hodogoron gear. Alright, that one's bleeding resistance. Speed sharpening, which actually can be useful. I just need a couple more Hornitar shells. Constitution's nice. Critical eye. I need a plate for that. That's gonna be hard to get. It also has punishing draw, which when you attack from drawing, you can add a stun effect. So it's probably best for greatsword users. Anyway. Although hammer and honeyhorn user myself, I could use that skill as well. And also quick sheath. Which actually I might make things a bit easier for me. But I want to see what Enid does. Oh, defense versus defense boost, windproof. Health boost, which is useful. Versus Slugger, which I got now. Thunder resistance and thunder attack. Which one do you use? I know, I don't want to lose my attack boost, but it might be worth it if I'm taking fewer cycles to sharpen. Also, Bishop could be good, and... Critical eye. So I might have to farm this. Dog off screen sometime. Try and get as much as I can. And I do want to check what quests I have available before I decide what to do next. Alright, let's see. Alright, still got the same ones as before. Got eggs and capturing Palumu. Also delivering more meat. Also, I think I completed these. I'm guessing these were the main quests that were considered optional quests, so might for actually before I go, I'm gonna head down to a tray yard. And there is something I want to check. Alright, so let's see. I can't make any of these yet. And actually, kind of think of it. Ooh, I do want to make. I got enough monster bone smalls to make one. But actually, what I wanted to check was here. I got more research points. Alright, let's see. What bounty should I go with next? Alright, investigations. That might give me an excuse to. Alright, there's a Hornetor one, Great Gyros. None for the dog. So I might not be able to. I might have to do it the old fashioned way. Ooh, but. I do want to take me this. Wait a minute, is there a better Hornetor? Let's see, target. Hornetor. I want to see what the best one would be for it. Got plenty of Hornetor ones, so. I'll go with this one just for the money, and it should allow me to get enough parts to make my doggy chest, but yeah, I'm gonna call it into this episode, so name it. Let's head to Poogie before we go. And Poogie likes us. I think next time I'll just do the delivery quest. So until next time, I want you to have a good day, everyone.